All right, here's my rough sketch, very, very rough sketch of my solar oven cart. I don't really want to spend much money on it, so I'm going to use all my scraps and stuff that I have laying around. I have the wheels here that I took off the lawnmower a while back. And I have this scrap of plywood that is 29 inches as wide as I'm going to make it on the inside, and 14 inches on the inside this way. And then I have this stuff that I've dug up that was for shelving in my safe. This is just, I don't know where I, it's just stuff I've had laying around. So the only thing I need now is I'm going to make the legs out of 2x3s. And probably not going to be able to find good 2x3s, so I'll buy some good 2x4s and cut them down. And I think I have everything else. I have the axle for the wheels here. I think I'm going to miter the corners. So I got to warn you, I'm not real good at mitering corners. But I'm going to do it. Actually, these two corners are the only ones that are going to have to be mitered here, because these are going to go past the end of it, and I'll have a solid piece that I'll nail in between them. So I'll just have to miter one end. Maybe I can do two good miters. And then a couple of cross braces, so when I'm dragging it, the legs won't flex. This is going to be the handle end down here. Have a couple of cross pieces going across either end so the legs don't flex inward or outward. On the inside of this rectangle I'm going to build, I'm going to put a lip at the bottom edge of it all the way around, so the plywood will set down in here on that lip. And screw it, glue it, stain it, seal it, and see if I can't keep it under, you know, $20. I think I can. I think I have pretty much everything, but we'll know in a minute. All right, I'm fixing to run to the lumber yard and get me a good 2x4 that I can... Oh, the height is going to be about, I think, 31-inch legs is what I've got figured. Yeah. Okay, see you in a bit. Off to the lumber yard. I tell you, I'm probably not going to miter the corners. I'm just not good at that mitering. And this is not going to be a piece of indoor furniture. So I'm going to make this strong and sturdy and not as pretty. I'm going for stronger joints versus pretty joints. And that's the main reason. And the other reason is, you know, I don't do a lot of mitered joints. And the only thing I have to do a mitered joint on is this. And it's not... Anyway, I'm just not really good or experienced at miter joints. I've done them before, and you can doctor them up and make them look better than they really are. But I just don't want to do that on this. So, that's basically what I've got here. Now I've got to draw out. I'm just going to do like a little decorative curve here and round it on the end. And then a dowel, a closet rod dowel, will go through here. Through here, and that's what you'll pick it up and move it around on. And the legs are going to have to come up the inside and attach to this and this, just so they don't move, because I am going to be using this and dragging it around on, you know, lumpy bumpy yard. So it's going to have to be pretty sturdy. So all right, I've got all I can get cut now. Actually, I can cut my a little ledge that I'm going to put in there and set the plywood on, so maybe I'll go ahead and do that and then go get some nice legs. All right, I'm back from the hardware store, lumber yard, and I've got this I just got it, you know, stuck, laid together, nothing screwed, nothing's hammered. I've got this cut out. Now, I think I'm going to make the strips that are going to go underneath this, that this plywood piece is going to set on. I'm going to cut them out. and I'm going to go ahead and attach them to the bottom edge of this and the bottom edge of that and that one and this one. And get them glued and screwed. And then I'm going to sand these sides really nice, because it'll just be easier to sand them when they're apart, you know, like up under here. And I'm not gonna like put a rod around them. I'm just gonna smooth them up. And what I'm really wanting to do is just smooth the faces more than anything. I put these ends on my belt sander right there. And then I'm just gonna sand the sides nice and smooth and just kind of knock the corners off of these. Okay. Alrighty, that's what I'm gonna do next. Okay, I got it all glued and screwed, clamped, sanded it down, put it together, screwed it, glued it, and let that dry overnight. In the meantime, made the legs. The legs are 34 and a half long by 1 3/16 inch thick and 2 5/8 inch wide. This was just a 2x4 that I run through my table saw here and squared them up, because you just can't find any square 2x4s. You can't. So now on the top of all of these, I'm going to knock a 45 like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to screw them to the outside here. And there's just no way of coming up underneath this and having enough to screw onto. So I'm going to put them on the outside, and I'll cut a 45 on this, and then I'll sand it and smooth it up, and it'll look nice. So what I'm going to do now, while I've got these not mounted, I'm going to sand them all up and get my saw marks out of it, and might get them screwed on. I don't know yet. We'll see when I get these all sanded. Free will and predestination. Myself. This is upside down, of course. And what I'm doing now, is I got to put glue in these holes and put these plugs in over the screws. And I started off I was just gonna throw something together, but I decided to make it a little nicer. All right, we're square plumbing level. I'm fixing to hammer these in, glue them in all the way around. And tell you what, I'm also gonna put a table shelf underneath here, and it's gonna be slatted going this way, and that's gonna help make this even sturdier. I'm gonna probably knock these 1x4s here. I got a piece over there. I'm probably gonna do 1-inch strips is what I'm gonna do. I'll knock these all down to 1 inch. I'll have plenty. All right, let me get these plugs in, and I'll put this thing on its feet, and we can have a look. All right, got a little more done. I've got my bracketry put up here for the shelf I'm going to put on there. I'm not going to set it down yet. I'm just going to let all these glue joints. I think what I'll do is cut my slats. All these are getting cut down to about 1¼ inches wide. And I'll just start cutting them up in the right length. So let me get after that. Okay, let's see, do I want to screw them on now or what? I got a whole bunch of sanding on these I got to do. I think I'll do that. What the heck, I'm all dirty. I'll go ahead and get the sanding done, and tomorrow I can sweep and then just screw them down and stain it and put a couple of coats of polyurethane on it. Oh, and I'll have to do the wheels. I got to put nuts on and then cut the ends off. Well, I got all my holes drilled to mount my little slats here, but I don't want to use these number 6 by 1¼. They're just too big, because I'm screwing into wood this size, and I'm afraid it'll split the wood. So I bought some number 4s, but I couldn't find a number 4 that was 1¼, and an inch just does not go through this wood deep enough. That's just not enough to grab on. So I am countersinking these holes by about 1/8 of an inch using I forget what kind of drill bit that's called. it's for just what I'm doing. But I gotta do that. Then I'm gonna screw these down, screw it and glue it. Hit this with the sander one more time. I gotta knock these off, and wherever there's glue, try to sand it off. And then I'm gonna start staining and color. The color I'm going to use is Colonial Maple. We'll see. Alrighty, back to work. Well, I can honestly say I don't much care for that color. I'm hoping overnight maybe it'll darken up some. Or maybe the poly on it will change the color a little bit. Not a bit. I don't like that a bit. And it is cheap stain. It's the Ace Hardware brand stain. And it was pretty watery. Alrighty, I'm going to let that set overnight. And tomorrow is Thursday. I got to take my wife to get her another test at the hospital. So Friday I'll get that poly on there Friday, and maybe 2 coats if I get started early in the morning. See you then. That was a nice little project. About 90% of it was scrap and stuff I had laying around. I'll tell you what I actually bought was brass screws and a couple of 2x4s to make the legs out of. That was it.
Thanks for watching.